Derek, Tony, VarsitySportsNetwork.com. We're here at the University of Maryland for the Maryland State Softball Championships, and your Class 4A champions, the Severna Park Falcons of Coach Meredith McAllister. A few hours ago, it was raining. Severna Park was inside the Xfinity Center, kind of walking around, playing games. But then when game time came, boy, did they put on a show. In the biggest margin of victory in Class 4A history, Severna Park knocked off the, 13-0, they knock off the 2017 champion, the Jaguars of Northwest. And Coach McAllister, I'll just let you talk, man, with what these young ladies did this afternoon with so many distractions and everything. They just played.
So the first thing is, and the probably easiest one is, Marissa did a phenomenal job on the mound. You know, she threw every pitch I asked her to throw. I worked her down in some counts because there were some good batters that we were facing. And, you know, she's willing to throw off the plate. She's willing to throw whatever I ask of her. And she just does it day in and day out. And, you know, she really put on a show there today with an extremely good hitting lineup. Mm-hmm. Our defense was solid. They did exactly what they were supposed to do. Our outfield's quick. They were hopping and catching line drives. Our infield's quick. They were moving and getting the outs they were supposed to get. Offensively, I mean, that was just phenomenal. You know, it was hit, and then when we had like a little ground ball or something, we were beating it out with our speed. So, you know, we ran a squeeze play, you know, in order to get that 10th run in. And they executed every single thing we asked them to do today. They executed. We talked about pitch selection. We talked about, you know, getting the pitch that you want to hit. And I feel like all of them did an extremely good job of that today. And, you know, it was just a phenomenal job of hitting.
Was it a perfect game?
So they had 2 hits on Marissa. Mm-hmm. I don't know. So
just overall, the whole...
anytime you win is a perfect game, right? No, I mean, they did everything that they were supposed to do. They executed everything. So in my eyes, yes, that's a perfect game.
Yeah, and talk about the offense. You know, I have seen you guys a handful of times, but one thing I do know, Campbell Klein is a professional hitter. She's a professional hitter. I mean, just... Yes. Talk about her. And only a junior.
Yeah, she's worked very hard to be where she's going to be. She's actually coming here to Maryland, so she was excited to come and play on this field and, you know, kind of get a feel for what she was looking at. And, I mean, she's done it all year for us in the leadoff spot, you know, and there's been a few times she was walked early on, so, you know, putting Jessie behind her gave her a little bit of padding so that, you know, it's tough to walk her when you've got to face then Jessie and Marissa and Kylie and Emma. You know, we just hammer you with power after that. And, you know, we can use courtesy runners for Marissa and Abby, so then we add speed into that on top of Campbell's speed. And then the bottom of our lineup is all speed and girls who are extremely dynamic. They can righty slap, they can bunt, they can hit, and, I mean, obviously they drove in several runs today. So that entire lineup does exactly what it's supposed to do, and when they execute it, it's beautiful.
Yeah, yeah. And just talk about the leadership of this team. Talk about, you know, Marissa. Jessie's a senior, correct?
So our 4 seniors, Marissa's our starting pitcher, Jessie's our starting first baseman, Abby's our starting catcher, and Emily Summers is our starting right fielder. And they have all come up with huge plays anytime we needed it. You know, Emily Summers made some crazy catches over her back in the county championship game, you know, and she just hops and moves. Watching her warm up, she reads the ball so beautifully in the outfield. She gets rid of it so quickly. You know, Jessie over at first base, you know, she's so tall, but she can stretch, she can move, and she probably has the most accurate throw you've ever seen from anybody. She's crisp and she's quick. Marissa on the mound, we already talked about, she's just phenomenal. She's relaxed, she's poised. You know, most people think that she can't move and pick up a short ball, but she did exactly that today. Abby Becker behind the plate, just solid. You know, she's not flashy, but I don't think she lets a ball get by her. And Marissa's moving the ball. You know, it's coming with heat, it's coming hard and fast, and it's moving. And she's keeping everything in front of her. You know, she blocks several balls with girls over at first base, and we don't have a lot of players that move on us just because she's so dynamic behind the plate.
Yeah. At what point you felt this thing was coming to a head as far as playing your best, you know, and today kind of topping it off with a dynamite performance?
You're never certain. You know, you give them the tools, you hope that they're on it. You know, we had a good confidence building practice yesterday, you know, just taking some reps and just doing some light front toss at them, you know, letting him get confident coming in today, hitting. And then, you know, we did some solid warming up. We had to warm up two different times before this game. So, you know, we felt ready, we felt prepared. And they knew exactly what we expected of them. And that's all you can ask is, you know, hey, I'm behind you 1,000%, and you know exactly what I'm expecting you to do today. Your teammates know exactly what you're expected to do, and you can just relax and do it.
Right. You've been part of Severna Park softball for almost 2 decades now.
Yeah.
Just 2 decades as a player, now as a coach. I mean, just sum up your emotions.
Well, my sister came in 95, mm-hmm. and 96 was, I think that was it. So, no, my freshman year was 95, 96, and my sister was a senior that year. So she came in 4 years before that, and we got to play together, you know, her senior year. That was my freshman year, and, you know, I was a good player, I think. but, you know, it's nice to go out on the field and do it because you don't have to think, you don't have to go through all the, you know, all the what ifs. Should I do this? Should I do that? But when you're coaching, you know, you kind of have to do that. You have to think about it. But what's nice is we had a lot to use this year. You know, I've got girls on the bench that would have started on some of these other teams, you know, and we only had, I think, 2 girls made first team all county. And, you know, you can see it out there on this field today. We should have had more. You know, they're a phenomenal group. And so they made it easy. You know, it was just every practice was fun. Yeah, sometimes you pull a little bit of teeth, but, you know, it's Severna Park High School. You get good kids. You get phenomenal kids. They want to work. You know, they want to give you everything that they have to give. And if you just encourage them and give them a few more tools that they can utilize and talk to them about it, you know, they're all smart. They're all working hard. And, you know, they give for each other. They just want to play for each other. And, you know, that's the legacy that I remember from Severna Park High School. And that's what we try to do with our program.
All right. It's been more than a decade since Severna Park has hosted a championship trophy on a rainy, cloudy, all kinds of humid day. Was perfect, almost the perfect game for the Severna Park Falcons of Coach Meredith McAllister as they win the Class 4A title 13-0. That's right, 13-0 over Northwest. For VarsitySportsNetwork.com, I'm Derek Tone.